Now we come to the properties of
the cross product. Properties of the vector product of the properties of the vector product.
Okay.
The first thing is that
it is distributive. Okay.
The cross product distributes over the addition. Distributes over addition. Okay.
So what happens?
If I have A cross B plus C, then it becomes A cross B plus A cross C.
Okay? It becomes A cross B plus A cross C. We get the point? It becomes A cross B plus A cross C.
The second one says if it is lambda A cross B, then it can be taken as lambda A cross B or A cross lambda B or A cross lambda B. Lambda A cross B or A cross lambda B. Or if there were two things, for example, lambda 1 A cross lambda 2 B, that will give us lambda 1 lambda 2 A cross B,
and you can shuffle it the way you want. So you can say that it is lambda 1 lambda 2 A cross B, or you can say it is A cross lambda 1 lambda 2 B. It can be any of them. Okay. Now we'll use this to find out what the cross product actually is. I'll erase this. Okay. What the cross product actually is. So if A is given by A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, B is equal to B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap, then what will be A cross B? It will be A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap crossed with B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap. And that will give us A1 I cap cross B1 I cap plus A1 I cap cross B2 J cap plus A1 I cap cross B3 K cap plus A2. A2 starts, right? So A2 J cap into A1 I cap plus A2 J cap cross A2 B2, I'll write it below, plus A2 J cap cross A B2, sorry, B2 J cap plus A2 J cap cross B3 K cap plus A3 K cap cross A1 I cross B1 I cap plus A3 K cap cross B2 J cap plus A3 K cap cross B3 K cap. Huge, right? But it'll soon vanish.
What happens? This can be written as A1 B1 I cap cross I cap, gone. I'll draw this small circle here. Okay, this is I cap J cap, K cap, like that, So this becomes, by this formula, a1 b1 I cap cross I cap gone. Okay, zero. A1 b2 I cap cross j, a1 b2 I cap cross j cap plus a1 b3 I cap cross k cap plus a2 a1 j cap cross I cap, a2 b2 j cap cross j cap, that is zero. So I'm not writing that. a2 b3 j cap cross k cap plus a3 b1 k cap cross I cap plus a3 b2 k cap cross j cap plus a3 b3 k cap cross k cap is gone, zero. Now I'll use this. So I cross j is k, a1 b2, so it is a1 b2 k cap. I cap cross k is minus j. So minus, this was what? A1 b3, right? So minus a1 b3 j cap, right? This is j cross I. So j cross I is minus k. So minus a2 a1 k cap, okay? a2 b3, j cross k is I. So plus a2 b3 I cap, k cross I is, k cross I is minus j, k cross I is j, sorry. So plus a3 b1 j cap plus k cross j is minus I, so minus a3 b2 k cap. So it becomes, and it'll look a bit weird, it looks a bit weird, what have I written, k I, no, this is k cross j is minus I, sorry, this is minus I. So I club the I's together, the I cap coefficients, a2 b3 minus a3 minus a3 b2 I cap, minus a1 b3 minus a3 b1 j cap, okay, and plus why am I writing this as minus and these two as plus, it will soon become evident, that is a1 b2 minus a1 b2, a1 b2, where is another k, minus a2, this must be a2 b1, this is not a2 a1, this is a2 j into b1 k, right, b1 I cap, this a2 j cap into b1 I cap, so this is a2 b1, okay, so this is a1, this is a2 b1, okay, this is a2 b1. So a1 b2 minus a2 b1 k cap. Now it looks weird. How will we remember this? Seems very weird and complicated, but it is not. Since we know the concept of determinants, if I decide to express it like this, that I write ijk as the first row, followed by that, I write the coefficients of A, that is A1, A2, A3 below that. Why? Because A is the first vector. Had B been the first vector, I would have written B1, B2, B3. So A1, A2, A3. Then comes B1, B2, B3. We get that. Now just try to expand this. How do I expand a determinant? The first term. Into, I hide this, a2 b3 minus b2 a3, a2 b3 minus b2 a3, a2 this is a2 I cap is a2 b3, this is a2 b3, right, yep. A2 b3 minus b2 a3, okay, then minus j, so I'll write it below, minus j cap into a1 b3 minus b1 a3, okay, and plus k cap, okay, plus k cap into what, a1 b2 minus a2 b1 a1 b2 minus a2 b1
correct. Does it match with this? Yes, it does. So you do not have to remember it. We just have to write it like this: ijk followed by the coefficients of ijk of the vector which is first, and then followed by the coefficients of the vector that is later. And the coefficients should be corresponding. That means the coefficient of I should be below I, j should be below j, and k should be below k. Hope we understand.